Hello students, welcome back to the class. During the last class we have discussed about the steps of prevention of corruptions. What are the steps we have to take so that we can able to prevent corruption? In the last class we have discussed about corruption, that corruption is a social menace which is very harmful to the society, and this social menace is percolating slowly. It is spreading slowly throughout territories which are mainly operated by government in the public life. So the corruption, the root cause of corruptions, if you see, mainly the two important root cause of the corruptions are, one is greediness and selfishness. Whenever the man is very, very greedy, today's man we can find is quietly greedy and very selfish regarding money. The wants for money never satisfied. Because of this greedy nature, the corruptions are increasing. Okay, especially in the public office or in the various department or in the lower department, the corruptions are very high. And this is the main thing. So the main root cause of corruption is the two things. If these two things will be under control, then there will be no corruptions at all. Corruptions are dividing our society in the two ways. One is called as lawlessness society and one is called as poverty. So corruption is dividing the societies in the form of two things. One is in the society where there is no law, that is called as lawlessness society, and one is called as poverty, poorness. The society where we can find poor people are there, that is called as poverty. So why the corruptions are dividing into lawlessness and poverty, we have explained that. So even though a law was formulated by government, Prevention of Corruptions Act 1988, but corruptions are widely practicing. Okay, so rules and regulations, whenever the corruptions will propagate, it will affect the administrative system. Even though there is a perfect rules and regulations, so sometimes these corrupt officers will bend the rules and regulations by taking money. So the society will be completely lawlessness. It is lawlessness for those who have money, and they are giving certain amount of money in the form of corrupt, and these officials are taking the money and they are bending the rules and regulations to avoid all these things. And second thing is poverty. Government is spending lot of schemes to the welfare of the people, but all the schemes are not reaching to the people. The main thing is the corrupt officers are taking everything. So before reaching it to the government, these corrupted officers who are at various level, they are taking away all the benefits of the ordinary people. And that's why still the poverty and the problems of the people remain same. Now here if you see that, one point is corruptions have some negative effects in, and we have already seen that some steps we have to take so that we can able to avoid the corruptions. The first important steps is we should avoid all this point like devoid of temptations like greediness and selfish nature, we have to avoid. And whenever if we are avoiding this all selfish nature and greedy nature, then we can able to avoid the corruptions. And second thing is we have to introduce the technology, children. Whenever if you are introducing some maximum technology, so this technology, what they will do, they will control the corruptions. Okay, now if you see in the banking sectors, nowadays in the railway sectors also, okay, in the various sectors if you see, now we can able to do the online transactions, that is also one form of technology. We can able to say 90% of the administrations, if it is replaced with the technology, there will be no corruption. Because the main problem of corruption is human. There are some people and some officers are taking corruption. When these officers are replaced by machines, then there will be no corruptions at all. So the only one way is replacing the humans with the technology. Whenever the human beings are replaced with the technology, the work will be done very faster and the corruptions will be under control. Okay, so the best thing is technology should be replaced. Yeah, human should be replaced with technology. The third important way we can able to control the corruption, media, children. Media plays a very important role. Day and night the media will work for the corrupt practices. So wherever the corruptions are involving, whatever the officers are involved in corruption, they will expose all these officers in front of public. And second thing is civil society. Whenever the society, educated societies can able to control corruptions, because in educated societies people have right to information. They can utilize the right to information. Right to information are there everywhere else. That is a fundamental right. But in villages, people are not using the right to information because they do not know how. There are many sections of the people, they have no time, they are not utilizing the right to information properly. But there are some civil societies where the people are educated, they are utilizing the Right to Information Act, where the government should be transparent and accountability to the people. Okay, the government will be transparent, the people can know that whatever the money they are paying to the government in the form of tax, whether that amount is spending for the welfare, activities are not. So that is one point. So only the educated peoples will come forward, and these educated peoples, they have a right to obtain the information. So from this information they can able to justify whether the government is working well or not. And also we know that in order to control the corruptions, there are some negative, corruption is a negative impact for the society. The result is, if you see, the whatever the trust will be there, the trust between the government and the people completely will be less. Imagine that when the government will not, when the most of the corrupt government will form, then whatever the trust, whatever the belief will be there regarding government, that also completely will be decreases. So corruption is a bad impact upon the government as well as society also. In India, we can find that consciousness is going against corruption because of implementation of Right to Information Act. So here, if you see that government of India has started one act which is called Right to Information. According to this act, the consciousness among the people have greatly increased, okay, against corruptions. Now the people are aware also intolerance against growing practices of corruptions. Nowadays the people are also intolerant, they are educated, they are coming forward and raising their voice against corruptions. So this is the main thing, these are the steps. So here what we have studied, students, here we have studied that corruption is one of the social menace, it's a social problem, okay, this will affect the society, and this is slowly spreading throughout all the territories which are operated by government in the public life. And if you see the corruption, the root cause of corruption is nothing but greediness and selfishness is the root cause for the corruption, and due to the corruption the society was divided into lawlessness society and one is called as poverty. The society where there is no proper law, the societies where the laws are not formulated, that is called as lawlessness society, and one is called as poverty. Now corruption is very important, corruption is needed, okay, and the corruption should be removed, okay. In order to remove the corruption, the first important thing is the people should avoid all important form of temptations. They should be devoid all these things. Second thing is introduction of technology in the administration by the government. The government wanted to control the corruption, technology must be introduced, because the technology does not know how to be, technology does not know about corruption. If all human beings are mainly responsible, because there are some human beings who are involving in the corruption practices. If human beings are replaced with the technology, then corruptions automatically will be removed and corruptions will be under control. So this is the only one way. Next one is media. If the media is very good, the media every time, a good media plays a very important role, because this media played corruptive practices, whatever the evil and corrupt practices which are going on in the society, they will go and they will expose that in front of people. Our next one is civil society. The societies where there is educated peoples, they place a very important role. Whatever the societies where you can find the people are educated, they place very important role. Okay, the vigilant society, because in this civil society where we can find the people will use Right to Information in a proper way. Right to Information Act. Result is corruption is a negative impact on the society. Because of that corruption, the trust between the government and the people also decreases. Whenever the corruption practices are increasing, the hope, whatever the belief, people, whatever the people has a belief upon government, that also automatically will decrease. So that's why in India, a consciousness is growing on regarding corruption because of implementation of Right to Information Act. After the implementation of Right to Information Act, the consciousness were also increased. Now people were quietly intolerant and growing practices against corruptions. Nowadays people were also intolerant against practices of corruptions. So children, this is about the step. We have discussed steps to prevent corruptions. Okay, in the next class we will come with a new topic. Thank you very much.